Hi guys, and welcome in this presentation. I'm Anthony.
And I'm Adrian.
And today, we're going to talk about some very interesting stuff, such as multimodal camera setup,
online distillation,
and data augmentation.
Let's go! Multimodal and multi-view distillation for real-time player detection on a football field. That's our 2020 CVsports paper, and we are very glad to present it to you safely in this new format.
Let's imagine that you've built a football field in your town. As a very popular sport, it is often used by kids, teams, and other football amateurs. Therefore, you would like to monitor the occupancy of your soccer field to prove that it was a good investment and that all the town should do it as well. How would you do that efficiently?
With a football field, a challenge resides in its size. It's large. Therefore, several regular cameras must be used to cover the whole field, which makes the setup complex and expensive. As an alternative, a single wide-angle fisheye camera can be used. But this type of lens heavily deforms the players and makes an automatic monitoring difficult.
Another difficulty comes from different weather conditions. Poor lighting, rain, shadows, mist, all these elements can significantly reduce the ability of standard algorithms to detect the players on the field. But don't worry, they can be handled all at once with the help of a single device, a thermal camera. Since the human body generally has a higher temperature than the background, it makes the player detection an easy task. However, these cameras are expensive and they have a very narrow field of view.
Okay, so if I sum this up, we want to detect all the players on the football field. We can have a cheap fisheye camera that sees it all but with a debatable quality. And we can have a thermal camera that makes the detection task super easy on a portion of the field. Well, then I think we've got everything we need to solve our problem. Ladies and gentlemen, in this work, we will detect the players on the thermal camera, transfer the detections on the fisheye image, perform some custom data augmentation to generate fake detections everywhere in the fisheye image, and train a network on the fisheye image so that at inference time, we have the occupancy monitoring.
And that is great. Let's get started. So first, we need to capture some data. For that, we have our colleague back there in Denmark. Hey, Ida, could you please tell us more about the setup that you've installed?
Hi, guys. Of course. So, we have installed two cameras in one of Aalborg amateur football field. So, one is fisheye, that has a very wide angle, and the other one is the thermal that allows to see players very clearly. These two cameras are placed on a high pole next to the field. So, in this setup, the field of view, the thermal camera represent is 6% of the fisheye image, and it covers 22% of the football field as seen by the fisheye camera. And then we have to do some registration between two cameras so that each pixel of the thermal camera is projected to the fisheye camera. With that, we can have one-to-one matching between the players detected from thermal to fisheye. And of course, this is only a very small region in fisheye and the entire field. Yes, thank you.
Wow, thanks, Yuda. Before we go any further, let's go back exactly 1 year in time at the previous CV Sports workshop. When I see you again. Ah, the wonderful year of 2019, when we weren't afraid of gathering in full rooms and making our way in the crowded alleys of the poster session. It is in this context that we presented for the first time ever the concept of online distillation. The main objective is to produce real-time networks that keep on learning throughout the match and improve on the tasks they're supposed to perform. The first important component is a student network that is fast enough to work in real-time, and its weights will be regularly updated to adapt to the latest video conditions. This will also ensure that we have a good generalization on the current video. In order to train the student during the video, we need a second process that runs in parallel. a massive teacher network produces some surrogate ground truth at a much lower speed, but with a very high quality. These ground truths are then stored in an online dataset to be used to train a copy of the student network. At each epoch, the weights of the student are updated and it thus gets better and better and can even surpass the teacher as it is made specific to the video.
Ah, good old times. Okay, let's now prepare our data to use the online distillation approach in our particular context. As a teacher network, we reuse a YOLO network obtained in a previous work that detects players on the thermal camera. Using the camera calibration, we transfer the player bounding boxes to the fisheye images. By doing so, we obtain some surrogate ground truth annotations that we can use to train a student YOLO tiny network on the fisheye images.
Is that all? Unfortunately, no. If we train our network this way, it will only be able to detect the players that are inside the common region that is filmed by both cameras. Hence, we will need to create new annotations outside of these regions in order to be able to detect these players. This is where we have to be creative, literally. Control C, Control V. No doubt you recognize this life-saving shortcut that will be our best friend here. Since we know from the teacher network where the players are, we can extract them and then copy-paste them outside of that region. Of course, we will have to take into account the distortion of the fisheye lens, and we will have to scale, rotate, and maybe blend the new players so that the overall image looks realistic. Hence, we will have new players with known bounding boxes.
Awesome, but wait a minute. Don't get excited too soon. If we train our network with these new fake players and annotations, what will happen with the remaining real players that have not been erased? Well, for now, our student will be forced to detect the artificial players, but will be penalized for detecting the real ones. It will simply go mad.
To overcome this issue, we will use something as old as time, a background subtraction algorithm. Well, to be fair, the one that we use is still a bit fresh. It was developed in 2009 and is called Vibe. The main advantage of Vibe is that it is very sensitive to motion, so you're sure that all the players will be in the motion mask. The drawback is that it has quite some false positive. But one thing is for sure is that all your players will be segmented, and that is exactly what we need.
We can compute the motion masks for all the frames and dilate them to be sure that we completely enclose all the players. Where there is motion, we cannot be sure whether or not there is a player. So we simply zero out the loss of the students during training. This relaxes the training and ensures that we do not force avoiding detections where there might be players. On the counterpart, where there is no motion, and where we did not add artificial players, we are sure that there are no players to detect, and so we force the network to avoid predicting anything there.
Awesome! Now let's see how it performs on a real video. What you're about to see is the evolution of the performance in detection throughout the video. The network starts from scratch, so with no knowledge at all of what it is seeing or supposed to detect. Step by step, it will learn to detect the players not only in the common region, but also outside the common region, thanks to our custom data augmentation.
We also propose an ablation study in the paper, where we look at the effect of each component separately. As a short summary, you should retain that each element is important. If we remove the data augmentation part, the network is unable to make any prediction outside the common region. If we cancel the loss everywhere outside the common region, the network makes thousands of false predictions.
Now let's take a look at the players that will exit the common region. Our network is still able to detect them, even if the only ground truth that was provided comes from the data augmentation. This is a fantastic result, and it shows how powerful online distillation can be in various situations.
So cool! Okay, let's recap what we've seen in this video. We were interested in automatically monitoring a football field occupancy. We combined two modalities, with different views of the field, one from the fisheye camera and one from a thermal camera. We use the player detector available for the thermal camera to obtain, by projection, surrogate annotations on a portion of the fisheye camera.
From this area, we cropped and copy-pasted the players and their bounding boxes into the remaining part of the image to create artificial players with known ground truth. To avoid misleading the network with the remaining non-erased players, we use a background subtraction algorithm so that the parts of the image that are in motion are not taken into account in the training process. Our student is constantly adapted to the latest match condition and weather condition with an online distillation strategy. Finally, we saw how amazing the results are.
And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed this presentation. If you have any question, please feel free to contact us. And see you next time. Bye.
Bye.